Hello and good morning friends. My name is Karan Singh and you are watching Plastotech, the world of plastics. So friends, today I'm going to tell you about how many types of injection molding machine are there. So before wasting time, I'm going to start with our topic. So if you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel. To subscribe my channel, you have to press the subscribe button. Along with that, don't forget to press the bell icon for the latest notification. So moving towards the topic, as far as I have told you that injection molding machine are of basically four types. So which four types are of injection molding machine? Number one, plunger type injection molding. First one is plunger type injection molding. Another one is plunger type injection molding. Along with that, the third one is screw plunger type injection molding. And the last one, reciprocating screw type injection molding. These are basically four types of injection molding machine. There are many more, like rubber injection, like metal injection, like vertical injection. These all comes under these categories. So I'm going to describe about all these types of injection molding along with the video. So friends, moving toward the video, so let's start with the types of injection molding. So there's the video. So guys, starting with the plunger type injection molding, you can clearly see this is mold. This is cavity section and that is core section. Now I'm going to tell you about this is plunger and that is hopper. Plunger is just above the hopper. Now I'm going to charge the material, raw material in the hopper. This hopper is attached with barrel and barrel has some band heaters. Now I can set temperature from that controller. So I'm going to close out the mold. I have closed the mold. Now I will fix this mold at the nozzle tip. Now I have to clamp the mold. This is gear system. I'm clamping the mold with the gears. You can clearly see it. Now this plunger will move downward and it will inject the material which has been melted inside the barrel into the mold. This is done with some pressure. High pressure is needed to inject that particular material in the mold. This is plunger type injection molding machine because a single plunger we are using in this machine. So you can see that plunger moves back to its original position. Now we will charge the material, and the material which has been filled in the mold, we have left for it solidification for its cooling. Now at that particular time, the material cools down. Now we open the clamp. Now we will open the mold to take out our product. It's simple method. It's used in small scale industries for some small products. Now it's very rare we use these type of machines, but just for you all, just to tell you all, I'm here with this plunger type injection molding machine because you should know about each and everything related to the plastics. Now I have ejected out. You can clearly see that this is our project. I have ejected out this project. This is the flash. We will cut down the flash and our product is ready. So it's quite simple method. So this was the complete working of our plunger type injection molding machine. Now we will spray some releasing sprays. More releasing sprays, so it will help in ejecting out our product. So moving to the next. Now this is the working of screw plunger type injection molding. Screw plunger type injection molding and plunger type injection molding are quite common. In this type of machine, there are two chambers. One chamber is to plasticize the material, to melt the material, and another chamber is used for injecting the material inside the mold. So upper section consists of plasticizing chamber in which the hopper is attached. The material, we charge the material over the hopper and the material is being plasticized in the plasticizing chamber, and then the plasticized material will be transmitted to the injection plunger area. Then injection plunger will move forward and the material will be filled inside the cavities of the mold. You can clearly see it. The functioning of
screw is rotating and the material which is being plasticized has been accumulated in the injecting chamber. You can see that we have closed the mold has been clamped, and now the material is being charged from the hopper to the barrel. In the barrel section there is a screw which is rotating, and along with screw the barrel consists of some band heaters and screw both helps in plasticizing the raw material into the melted form. This melted raw material move toward another chamber which is called injection chamber. In that injection chamber there is a plunger moves forward, and the raw material which is in melted form is being injected inside the mold. Quite simple. Similarly, the function for plunger type injection molding machine is same. Instead of a screw which is in the plasticizing chamber, there is a single plunger. Plunger type and plunger type injection molding machine and screw plunger type injection molding machine, the functions of both the machines are quite similar, but the result and efficiency of screw plunger type machine is more efficient than plunger type injection molding machine. In plunger type injection molding machine, the raw material is plasticized by heaters, the band heaters which are being attached over the barrel, and then the plunger moves that raw material into the injection plunger, and then the injection plunger moves forward and the entire plasticized material is injected inside the mold. So you can clearly see it, quite simple method. You can see that plunger moves forward and the material is being injected inside the mold. So moving to the next, so guys, the machine which you are seeing is known as reciprocating type injection molding machine. Now you can clearly see the black substance are called heating elements. These black substance are attached to the barrel. Now inside the barrel there is a reciprocating screw. You can clearly see that this is known as reciprocating screw. That's why the name of machine is called reciprocating screw. So the reciprocating screw is divided in three zones, which are feed zone, transition zone and metering zone. In feed zone, the material is fed from the hopper to the barrel. Next is transition zone, also known as compression zone. Here the material is being compressed. And third is metering zone. In front of that screw, there is NRV which prevents the material to not return back inside the barrel at the time of injection. Now we charge the material from hopper to barrel. While rotating the screw backward, the material is being charged. Now we have filled our barrel with the plasticized raw material. Materials are basically in the granules form. Now it is time for injection. Now before injection, we have to close the mold. The mold will be closed by the clamping system, either it is toggle, ram or fully electric. So now the mold is closed. Mold consists of some cooling system. You can see clearly the blue color pipes are also known as cooling pipes. Either we cool down the mold with MTC, mold temperature controller, or with the water system cooling tower. So this is a simple cooling system. Now we will inject the plasticized raw material which has been accumulated inside the barrel. We are going to inject that material inside the mold. Simple method. Screw will move forward, the reciprocating screw will be moving forward, and the material accumulated over the tip of the screw will be injected inside the mold. This process is done with high pressure. This is the most common and efficient machine used in the plastic industries of injection molding, the high efficient machine and high earning machine. So now the screw will move backward. At that particular time the dosing will start. Dosing means the charging of material from barrel to hopper and then to plasticize that material. Now the part is being injected.